You're going to see right now a model of two vertebrae. Okay, two vertebrae. Okay, so this one here, so on the left of the screen, you'll see right here the yellow block. That is the vertebra, okay? And it's nice, it's a big vertebra, so you know it's the lumbar spine. Okay, we get that a little larger, okay? And here's the vertebra below. So this is a spinal motor unit, okay? And in between is a disc from the side, okay? Over here is a disc from the side as well. There is the spinal root, spinal nerve root coming out from the neural foramen. So if you hear any MRI, a neural foramen, that's what that is. It's, you know, you may see an MRI report a neural foraminal encroachment or neural foraminal stenosis. So the neural foramen, so foramen means window in Latin, okay? So window. And this opening is a window to the spinal column where the nerve emerges. The nerve branches from the spinal cord. In the lower lumbar area is the spinal, is the cauda equina, which does branch from the terminal end of the spinal cord. So that's the spinal nerve, okay? So the foramen is the opening, okay? And nerve, so neural foramen, okay? Now, when there's encroachment, it means that there's degeneration. So look at this one here. There's degeneration. These bony spurs are signs of degenerative arthritis. That's degeneration that occurs. This is an advanced degenerative model over here. So this occurred over the span of 30, probably 20 to 30 years. This is like stage 3 degeneration. Every 10 to 15 years it progresses. This is normal. This is the way the spine should be. This degeneration is not age-related. Just because someone's 50 or 60 years old doesn't necessarily mean they have to have degenerative arthritis. Yes, there is a tendency for some wear and tear over time and degenerative change over time, but not this advanced. This is pathologic. This is not normal. Okay, so neural encroachment is when either a disc encroaches into the or presses into the nerve area over here and closes that foramen. And it should be nice and open or patent. And when the degenerative bone spurs get in there, then it encroaches in there. So that's number one. And also, a stenosis means a narrowing in, okay, of the canal. So either the canal on the inside or the foramen. So if you hear neuroforaminal stenosis, that's what that is. So here's an example of a disc bulge encroaching onto the nerve root. So two things I want you to get about disc bulges. Number one, when there's disc damage, it is highly painful. It's discs release inflammatory byproducts, bradykinin, and other irritants, immune irritants, and it creates an immunological response, and inflammation is the first response. And one of the signs of inflammation is pain. So pain is related to inflammation when someone perceives that tissue damage. So discs are very painful, and so that's very important. And number two, in and of itself, number two, if a disc touches the nerve, it's even more pain. That pain shoots right down into the leg. Okay, I'll show you another picture about that in a moment. So you'll see that when an MRI says disc bulge, degenerative changes, there's different stages, all right? This is a very advanced stage, and that's something I really want you to really understand when you're considering that if this is happening there, this is very difficult to correct along the rest of the spine, very difficult to make immediate corrections. This takes time to heal. The inflammation takes time to diminish. The corrective stability of spine takes time to heal. This spinal motor unit is not stable anymore compared to this. The actual disc bulge on this, the actual disc level here and here is completely dried out. It's that's when you hear desiccated disc or desiccation. It's dried out. The water content is completely eliminated. The shock absorbing ability of the disc is gone. It's a major, major issue to the spine. And that's why it caused a lot of problems and debilitation. Let me show you this aerial view here, okay? So on this side, follow the cursor right here. Okay, so here is a normal disc. So it's an aerial view. So if I was looking from the top of my head straight down to the spine, right? So an aerial view, that's the top of the disc. The outer area are the annular fibers, fibrocartilage. The inner part is the nucleus pulposus. There's a spinal cord. So this would be somewhere from L2, which is the second lumbar vertebra, second low back vertebra, and above, okay? So it's just a model, so it's just an idea, okay, of what's going on with the anatomy. Here's the back part of the spine, and here's the front part of the spine. Look at the aerial view of the degenerative disc. So see these gaps in the annular fibers? Those are annular tears. You've never heard of annular tears. When there are annular tears, there's a weakness in the strong fibrocartilage disc ring. When there's a weakness, the inner nucleus pulposus begins to leak through. It can leak through, and it creates an inflammatory response. Very, very pain sensitive. Inflammatory response is very, very pain sensitive. When this begins to, so that's a minor bulge. When it begins to bulge even more, then this begins to be called a disc bulge. So that would, so this is a side view, and that's the aerial view. Okay, so you'll see there the disc bulge. Okay, so it starts off like this, and then it goes into there. Okay, now. So let me just see what else I have here. I'm going to show you another picture here. So you see what it looks like on a model. Now, this is what it looks like on an MRI, okay? So right here. Okay, so this is a lateral view of the lumbar spine. Here is the L5 vertebra, L5S1 disc, L4 vertebra, L4L5 disc, L3 vertebra, L3-L4 disc. Now, you see how this disc is nice and wide? Minor disc bulge. Nice and wide disc. That's good, but there's a minor disc bulge, so there's some kind of injury in there. And over here, it's a very degenerative disc. L5-S1 is moderate to severe. Disc space is lost, or disc height is lost, and a massive disc herniation going on here. So when the disc bulge advances from a bulge to a bigger protrusion, we can call it a disc herniation at that point. Or a disc protrusion. Okay, so at this point here, so if we look at, let me back up a bit. So 5, 4, 3. So typically the spinal cord will end at about L2. So somewhere up here, L1, L2 is where the spinal cord ends. And inside here, inside the spinal canal, is a branch of nerves called the cauda equina. You might have heard of cauda equina. It's called cauda equina because it resembles a horse's tail. Cauda for tail, equina for horse, Latin, right? And each nerve of the cauda equina emerges from those neural foramen that I was telling you about, okay? So here's my models from there, okay? So emerge from there. And they branch into the lower abdominal area, the pelvic region, and then the legs, okay? So let me show you the next picture, okay? So here's an example of, so let's go here first. So there's the vertebra disc, lateral disc, posterior lateral disc bulge, irritating the nerve. Now, sometimes the nerve may actually physically irritate it and impinge the nerve. Sorry, sometimes the disc may actually irritate the nerve and impinge it. Sometimes they may just be the chemical inflammatory irritation that can also irritate the nerve, the swelling of that local area. Okay, but when that nerve is irritated, watch what happens. So here it is again. Okay, so L5S1, L4L5. These nerves, so L405 and then the sacral nerves branch and form the sciatic nerve. Here's the sciatic nerve right there. And you'll see that the distribution, so an L5 distribution will typically go down to the foot. An L4 distribution goes somewhere around the thigh. But this whole area is usually involved. So there's not just discs and nerves involved. There's spinal tissues like ligaments and bones that refer pain. So the whole low back problem cannot just trigger a shooting a pain down the leg along the nerve pattern when the nerves are impinged, but can also be an achy, dull pain that goes down to the thigh and to the knee. So a lot of times people think that they have a sciatica when it's not a sciatica. It's basically referral pain from the sacral region and L405 region, most of the sacral region. But when there's that shooting, sharp, electric-type pain into the calf and foot, or that burning sharp pain into the calf area around here, or numbness into the toes, we know that the nerves are involved. So those are typical signs of disc bulges or herniations in L405. So over here again, you know, just the more visual. Some people are visual when it comes to learning. So I want to give you a lot of visuals. Again, here's a diagrammatic version of that motor unit in the spine. So vertebra disc. Posterior lateral protrusion. Here they call it a disc, herniated disc. Irritates the nerve. And again, here's the lumbar spine, and you see all that red, which would indicate a local inflammatory response. So when I check someone, I press right inside here. They tell me that it really hurts. That's a local inflammatory response. And then when it hits that nerve, it goes into the leg like you saw earlier over here. Then that's a radiating response. And when it's the tissues around here, like the bony ligament tissues that refer pain, that's a referral response. So it's through the consultation and examination and the case review, the MRI and x-rays, we put all this information together to determine the tissues involved, the alignment of the spine, and then from there, we can determine the corrective care protocol. So that's the kind of work that we do in our office with corrective chiropractic care, getting treatment and care for a disc bulge injury. Degenerative spinal condition is a all-encompassing corrective approach. And yes, you can add the other modalities in there for a multimodal type of rehab situation. I highly recommend that. But if you're not getting the spine assessed and aligned properly, then it's not going to solve the problem permanently or at least for a long term. Back pain is one of the most common conditions that brings people to a medical doctor's office next to the common flu, and many times it's mishandled and misdiagnosed and mistreated. So if I could give people some direction and answers onto what could be going on when they have a certain diagnosis or when they have a certain problem with their spine or pain, if I can direct them towards some kind of care like corrective chiropractic care in their community, then I know that I've served my purpose. And if you get something out of this, let me know. Click that like button, share with your family and friends, and tell your people and friends to subscribe to this channel so we can help more and more people together. This is Dr. Walter from Vaughan, Ontario, Canada.